Today we have a problem which was sent to me by one of my subscribers again. It starts with a square, then we're going to lean another smaller square next to it so that their bottom sides are on the same line, just as you can see on the sketch. Then we're going to have another square which we're going to tilt and slide into the position so that its upright corner is located on the upright corner of the smaller square and the down left corner is located on the down left corner of the bigger square. Also, the upper right corner of our bigger square is located on the upper side of our tilted square, as you can see on the sketch. If we know for a certain that the area of the bigger blue square is equal to 4, can we somehow calculate the area of the smaller red square? As I mentioned earlier, this problem was presented to me by one of my subscribers, Herbie, so thank you, Herbie, for this nice challenge. Now, as always, if you guys want to solve this one for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So, I will offer you two different methods to solve this problem. The first method will be using the triangle similarity. So, let's start with the fact that the area of the blue square is equal to 4. This means that we can easily calculate the sides of this square as 2. Next, we can mark the sides of our small red square as A. Then, we can mark the sides of our tilted square as B. Next, let's label all the vertices of our squares. Let's first label the vertices of our bigger square as A, B, C, and D. Then we will label the remaining vertices of the smaller square as E, F, and G, and finally the remaining vertices of tilted square as M and N. Now, just as a quick reminder, if we have a square with the side X, and if we pull the diagonal of this square, the length of the diagonal must be equal to the side of the square times square root of 2. We will use this in our case. First, we will pull the diagonal AF of our tilted square. And since we can see that the side of this square is equal to B, this means that the diagonal of this square is equal to B square root of 2. We can do the same for our big square ABCD. We can pull the diagonal AC, and since the side of this square is equal to 2, this means that this diagonal must have the length of 2 square root of 2. Next, let's take a look at the angle NAC. And let's label this angle as theta. We know that the angle NAF must be equal to 45 degrees, since AF is the diagonal of our tilted square. This means that the remaining angle CAF must be equal to the difference between 45 degrees and the angle theta. Now, we also know that the angle CAE must be equal to 45 degrees as well, because AC is the diagonal of our bigger square. So this means that the remaining angle FAE must be equal to the angle theta again. Now, let's have a look at the right angle triangle ACN. And let's also have a look at the right angle triangle AEF. We will isolate those two triangles. And you can notice that they share two pairs of the same angles, which means that those two triangles are actually similar. Now, let's pull the values for their sides from the sketch. You can see that the length BE is actually equal to the side of our smaller square, which means that the base of our blue triangle must be equal to 2 plus A. Now we can use the rule of similarity. We can say that the relation between the hypotenuse is equal to the relation between the bases of our two triangles. And we can work through this equation. We can first simplify it by canceling square root of 2, and then we can cross multiply to get the following. Now let's again have a look at our blue right angle triangle AEF. We can use the Pythagorean theorem. We can say that the hypotenuse AF squared is equal to the sum of the legs AE squared and EF squared. Now let's substitute our values from the sketch, and then let's put everything to the square. Of course, we will expand the first term on the right by using the square of binomial and get the following. Now you can see that on the left side of this equation we have the value of b squared, which we already got earlier, so we are just going to substitute the b squared for 4 plus 2a. Then we're going to simplify this equation further by dividing everything with 2 and get the following. Now we will cancel 2a on the both sides of the equation and finally get that a squared is equal to 4 minus 2, which means that a squared is equal to 2. Now, remember, we are looking for the area of the red square with the side of a. So this means that the area of this square is equal to a squared, and of course we are just going to substitute the value of a squared, and we will get that the area of our wanted red square is equal to 2 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method, which will also use the triangle similarity, but this time we will not use the values of diagonals. We will start by again labeling the vertices of the blue square as A, B, C, D, and of course the remaining vertices of the red square as E, F, G. Now, we know that the area of the blue square is equal to 4, so we can say that the sides of this square are equal to 2. And we can also label the sides of our red square as A. Now, let's have a look at the line GC. We can get this line by using the sides of our big and small square. If we clear our image a little bit and slide those sides, you can see that the line GC will actually represent the difference between those two sides, so it must have the length of 2 minus a. Now let's pull a line from point A to point F, and let's have a look at the angle FAE. This angle will actually be equal to the angle CFG on the top. But if you are wondering why is that, well, this time I will have a little challenge for you. Since I'm really, really blessed and grateful that I have really awesome mathematicians among my viewers and subscribers, I will challenge you guys to tell me which mathematical rule or rules are we using to conclude that those two angles are actually equal. And please write your answers down in the comment section below. Now, let's continue by taking a look at the triangle AEF. This is the right angle triangle. Also, let's have a look at the triangle CFG. This is the right triangle again. Now, we can isolate those two triangles, and again, you can notice that those two triangles have two pairs of the same angles, so they are similar triangles. Now let's just pull the values for their bases and the heights from the sketch, and let's use the rule of similarity again. We can say that the relation between their bases is equal to the relation between their heights, and we will get the following equation. Now we will cross multiply this to get the following. On the right side of this equation, you can notice that we have a classical formula for difference of squares. So, this means that a squared is equal to 2 squared minus a squared. Now, we can simplify this and finally get that a squared is equal to 2. Remember, we're looking for the area of the red square with the side of a, so the area of this square must be equal to a squared. Now with those two final equations combined, we can conclude that the area of our red square is equal to 2 squared units, and again, we have our solution. Well, I hope you guys really enjoyed this problem. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section as you always do. And until next time, as always, see you all and take care.